Hi, my name is Mingchao Jiang. I'm a PhD student from Rice University. Today, I'm really glad to share a project about fuchsia image classification. It is called Just Use a Library of Pre-trained Feature Extractor and Simple Classifier. This work is collaborated with Arkabandhu Chowdhury, Sora Chowdhury, and Chris Germain.
So what is a fuchsia learning? Even at the current age of big data, the assumption for having a large labeled training set is not always realistic. In comparison to the traditional learning problem, where we have classes with many samples, the fuchsia learning has classes with a few samples. The fuchsia setting requires a large model to generalize well beyond the few available training instances. I'd like to specify the particular fuchsia problem we're looking here is called cross-domain fuchsia learning, which is the most difficult and general variant of fuchsia learning. We want a fuchsia learner app that can take a very small sample from certain distribution and learn to classify the future samples from that distribution. However, the fuchsia samples are very small, so we cannot afford any data split. Neither the sample or its distribution is available to us when developing or validating the learner app. The goal is to build a learner app truly off the shelf and works on virtually any new distribution. Recent work suggests that the transfer learning method is quite promising in the fuchsia setting. For example, the baseline method built one linear classifier on top of one pre-trained CNN. Selecting from universal representations approach argues that diversity in features is best obtained through the diversity in datasets. And the big transfer model trained a very deep CNN on a massive dataset. The question is there an even simpler method? Consider this idea. We use a deep CNN trained on a diverse dataset, such as ResNet 18 trained on ImageNet 1K. After that, we simply remove the classifier on top and replace that with one MLP. And we train this MLP from scratch on fuchsia problems and perform a hyperparameters validation on an external dataset such as CUB birds. And that's it. That's a method we call library-based learner because we are using the published library-based CNN directly. In our case, there are 9 different variants of ResNet and DenseNet. The library-based learner has 2 components. The first one is the pre-trained feature extractors, and the second one is a simple classifier. We find out a single high-quality dataset is actually all that is needed for fuchsia learning, and adding more feature extractors trained on that dataset is actually the best path to achieve higher performance. Here we compare against 9 standard methods over 8 different datasets, and we find out the worst library-based learner beats the best standard method on 5 out of 8 datasets. Taking this 5-way five-shot problem example, here we show the performance on aircraft dataset and fungi dataset. There is a massive gap between the worst library-based learner versus the best standard method. On aircraft, it's 61 versus 47. On fungi, it's 77 versus 67. We also notice there is a big gap between the best and worst library-based learner, which became one of our concerns. Because we want the best performance every single time. However, there is no clear pattern on which feature extractor might work better on which dataset. It is very natural to ask, is that possible to use all of these feature extractors to develop an even better fuchsia learner? We found a very simple approach. Just ensemble all of those library feature extractors. Here, we concatenate the features extracted from all 9 different libraries, and we are talking about 13K plus features. We just build one MLP with L2 regularization on top of that, and we call this method for library learner. Let's take a look at its performance. Here, we compare the for library learner versus the best single learner. As we can tell, the for library learner always beats the best single learner, especially when weights increase. That means the fuchsia problem is getting more difficult. The for library learner wins even more. We were wondering why does library-based learner work so well? We find out the first reason is because the diversity of high-quality feature extractors is the key for the fusion learning. Even many trained on the same dataset, like ImageNet 1K, is actually a good option. Here we have different fusion problems and the top feature they picked. As we can tell, the different fusion problems favor different feature extractors. We also find out the CNN's diversity outweighs the data size. We compare the ensemble of 9 CNN trained on the ImageNet 1K dataset versus the deeper CNN trained on the full ImageNet 21K, and the first one outperformed the later one. Another reason we find out is the fusion fine-tuning is surprisingly easy. Even we're talking about 13K plus feature, the weights of NLP trained with one shot actually match the weight trained with the full data. That is telling us one image offers a lot of information, and number of training points has smaller effects than we expected. In conclusion, we found a simplest transfer learning method. Rather than pre-train a huge model on a massive dataset, we can just use a group of smaller published feature extractor directly, with MLP and L2 regularization on top. It turned out it's very hard to beat. The key novelty here is its simplicity, and welcome to stop by our poster to find more.